While I'm holding on to my daydream, smoking on some OG. While I'm homegrown and I'm leaning on to my love. My love.
What is up, everybody?
Currently in Los Angeles, California for the next few days. We just wanted to introduce this vlog, say hello.
Yeah, LA vlog, let's go.
Hope you enjoy.
All right, we are heading to Big Daddy's. We've taken y'all here before. It's one of our favorite stores.
It's an antique shop that we actually discovered in San Francisco.
And I think that one closed down.
That one closed down, but their main location's in LA. So we've been to both, but we always like to come every time we're in LA.
They have a second location somewhere in Northern California now.
Yeah.
I think they closed down the San Francisco location and opened up another one.
Near Silicon Valley.
Something like that. But we love it. We came here last time we came to LA.
Yeah.
And just did like a walk around, but we're actually now in the market to buy some items because we're still decorating our Nashville house. So
this is like, I think the end all of like antique shops. Mm-hmm. Big Daddy's is the best. He actually goes to Round Top and sources a lot of his stuff from there. So
yeah, he also used to sell at Round Top. I think I could be wrong. I know he sells to like designers, interior designers. He sells to other antique shops. So yeah. Like some of the Nashville antique shops we go to, they used to buy from Big Daddy's. Even like places in Sonoma and stuff, they would buy their stuff at Big Daddy's too and then resell it. But he's just like, he has the eye, he knows what's in, he knows what's gonna be in. He just has good stuff. And
he's
so
good style.
Yeah, good style.
Yeah, we really like his stuff. So we're like stoked. We're like, let's go. Because we're still, as you guys know, furnishing the house. It takes a lot of time. And, there's just not that many antique stores in Nashville. So.
But we're really excited. Like, it almost feels like.
We're going to find things. That's how I think.
And it's cool because when we found out we were coming here for the work trip, we were like, let's go a day early. And like a big piece of that was to go to Big Daddy's to antique shop. So.
LA is good furniture shopping. Yeah. Like, I wish we could discover some more places.
There's probably some others that are similar to Big Daddy's, but yeah. Big Daddy's is just our favorite. It's like a must go to. We'll take you with us, obviously. We're gonna show you like the whole store.
Yeah.
We've showed in other vlogs before, but as a refresh, we'll do a big loop. We'll show you what we're looking at, show you what we might end up buying, all that kind of stuff. So we wanted to come on our like first moment we got here to look around. And if there's any items that we wanna like contemplate or like discuss, mm-hmm. we can always go back like in a couple days to actually make the purchase. So
yeah. Oh. Excited.
I know, we're excited. We'll see you there. Alrighty, we just pulled up. Here you go, Big Daddy Antiques.
Exciting.
So exciting.
This is like
kind of
nice candy.
Yeah. You know how we met back then. Acting like we understand art. You was in my head like the one joint that play on the song from your phone. You get into the car, but still too slow. Maybe that's on me. His IG on your laptop screen. I was only getting you to close at 10. That's no move, girl, that's IT. Now here we are. A few more friends and a lot more summers. All my friends want your friends' numbers. And this is one song, though, that's for another, okay.
They're cool, though.
They're so
cool. These look good in our living room. That's the two chairs. It's like a change-up, you know? Like, boom, boom. And it's a lighter wood, so it kind of is a contrast to, like, the dark dining coffee table.
Totally.
Oh, it's so nice.
But that's too big for your bourbon room. You should get a neon sign that says bourbon.
Bourbon, yeah.
Like, okay, these are actually kind of perfect for the upstairs bedroom. There's two. I saw another one over there.
Oh, yeah. Or for the coffee table?
Perfect shape.
I'm kidding. I'm joking. I do like the neon. That's really pretty. It's a cool color, too. Like, against the dark.
Totally. I think that wall is 60.
Cool desk for your office? No, that's not bigger than that wall. There's no way.
The wall is, I think it's like 68 or something.
Cool piece of art.
I know.
I really like their art. They have good art here.
This is pretty.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they do have good art. Oh, I feel like we haven't seen good like home furnishings in a while.
I know.
I ain't putting this song on without you.
These planters are awesome. Yeah, but it has to be like you want the base of it to be
the right depth. I think that we can get the measurement online, but That looks perfect.
We're looking at new planters for our olive tree, the fake olive trees that we have. It's a RH olive tree inside of a big RH pot.
Our planters are
but the planters
so big.
Are so big that
it it's weird.
It's just hard to like put them anywhere too. They take up so much space.
They can't fit anywhere.
They're nice. We like them. They're just so big and kind of awkward. Ooh, look at this. Uh-oh. Looks like she lost something there.
Is it supposed to be like that?
I don't know. Should we give her a heads up? Love dripping plants.
Love. That looks really good because I see those style planters everywhere, but I like didn't know how, I've never seen plants
like it done like that.
That.
Yeah. What is that, trailing
looks
rosemary?
Really pretty. I don't know. What is that? It's not rosemary. Trailing something. Oh, they just have it up high. They just stack things
so it's high.
Smart.
I mean, you could have dirt up to the top and have it pouring out too,
you
if it's real.
Like, yeah.
There's a nice use of suitcases stacked, like on top of a cabinet, or if you have like a little bookshelf, that's kind of a nice way to do it. Probably makes the room a little taller or look a little taller. Oh, these little stools are kind of cool. They're basically like butterfly joints.
Yeah. Modern.
Kind of cool. Like an old picture that kind of has like some like scruff to it.
For sure.
And you can tell it's old and antique, but it still has like its original like art on it.
Yeah, like, I love it.
It's kind of cool, huh?
I love like the antique gold frames. They're
yeah.
Such
could that look good
with, like,
where my current Indian painting is, like in the middle?
Yeah.
I do want
some. It kind of has these deeper colors in it, so it would
right. And like look on camera, it even looks like you can actually see the art.
Oh yeah, oh my god, it's gorgeous. And it's kind of like city, like.
Yeah, that's cool.
For the time on?
And I kind of want to do almost like a gallery wall there.
Yeah.
Like not behind, like if I don't do it where the Indian painting is, where my desk is going to go.
Yeah.
I kind of want like a
little gallery.
Gallery, like where you first walk into the front door on that wall like to the left.
That'd be really cool.
Yeah.
It's like with a bunch of little vintage mismatch.
Yeah.
That'd be sick.
Hello, sir. I love old art.
I love these lamps. They're really super tall, like 6'5" or something. There's two of them. They're gorgeous.
Best Buy, both at the Big Daddy's in San Francisco and Summer House in Mill Valley, is like some of the mirrors they have. Not necessarily that one's
really
too rustic,
big ones,
but just like the sizing of them. They're so grand.
Totally.
You have to have a spot for it, but like our house is grand, but there's no grand
walls to put something on. I know.
Yeah.
Unless
the
you like
kind of compartmentalized.
Agree.
Like think about the one that goes into our kitchen.
Yeah.
It's like you have a walkway on either side, so it makes it smaller.
Yeah.
But like maybe something at like we're going up the stairs at the halfway point, having like a big piece of art or a big mirror right there could.
Yeah.
That's like a big grand wall.
I'm obsessed with these chairs. I love them. But I don't know where to put them. But they're so cool. I just love the color, the shape, the style. They're really like kind of oversized. They make like a statement. Really cool, but again, don't know where I put them. That's okay. These are gorgeous too. I love the color of them. And these are so pretty. Got a lot of small things too here. It's like not all big furniture, like lots of little things. So you should come check it out. They have the best stuff, you guys. Little things like this. This is cute. This would be cool to do on our entryway table. So this concept, like live plants inside a huge bowl, like that white one. Sorry, this song is so annoying, but something like that.
I've been trying to come up with a solution for my office and I have a lot of different ideas, but haven't landed on one. Storage is an issue. So I've thought about doing big like floor to ceiling built-ins.
Kind of like the ones I have in my office. Like I have the big built-ins with the shelves.
But they would look different. We hold like beauty products and stuff that I use for work and everything. Well, this piece, I was like, wait a second. I never thought about putting a vintage piece in there, but this could be a solution and get like custom shelves inside. And it could just go back against the back wall versus doing new built-ins. Mm-hmm. We just do a vintage piece.
Is that pine?
Yeah, but it's like hurt color.
What's nice about that too is because your office is in what's supposed to be the dining room. If we were to ever move or try to sell our house, we could still stage that area as
exactly.
a dining room.
And oh, it looks like these are two different pieces. Huh?
Yeah, they
this
are.
This is 90, which is the opening.
Of yeah, yeah.
Well, just saying, 8900.
Are they separate for sale, or is it like all one
vintage
piece?
Vintage wood cabinet with four glass doors on. So yeah. I think that's total.
I think you'd have to buy both.
Yeah.
I mean, one thing you could always do if we wanted, and this is just like a whole nother thought, is if you wanted to only use the bottom, we could save this for if we ever decided to like redo some of the kitchen cabinets. This could be like a built-in piece, like, or like the kitchens that have like modern shelving and modern cabinets, like, and then you also have like something built in, like that's a little vintage. I think it's 91. The bottom is 91.
That thing's exactly 90, isn't it?
Somewhere right around there. We would make it work.
But well, that would only be if we use the bottom and piece, like, and we put it in the side. If not, we would use the whole thing on the back
wall. On the back wall, yeah. It's nice. It's cool. Do you like this one? And did you want to, now that you have that idea in your head, do you want to check out the others? There's like three or four more in there.
I was looking at them, but they're all like a little intense. This one I like. It's kind of like simple. It's not too like gothic looking.
Yeah.
Like shabby chic. It's just like pretty plain, which I like.
Oh shoot, I wasn't recording.
Shut up.
Okay. Doesn't that kind of look like Wilson from Castaway?
It does.
The one thing I'm kind of looking for is like side tables for my bourbon room.
Side tables.
Like stuff like this. I mean, not this, but like, you know, smaller tables that would be like on either side of the couch or like in between two chairs. Table. Oh, I know. I need a coffee table. First I need two corner. Chairs.
Yeah.
So, looking for a little bit of everything.
Okay, we just panicked because we thought the camera was broken, but really the, memory card door just like wasn't shut all the way, so Hunter and I were like no. But I just found, I have just been dreaming of a light fixture for our dining space. It's currently like a beaded one there right now, and it's cute. It's just like not really our style, and I just saw this one and I'm like, this is exactly the style I've been thinking in my head, and it's so good. I don't think it's for sale, but it is gorgeous, and it's kind of like a I've been wanting like a flush mount, but gold, or sorry, brass, just like this, kind of sprawling out. It is so sick. I need it. It's literally the perfect light fixture. Like, how good would it look above our current, oh my god, with our chairs? It would just be mwah. It would look so good. Okay, I need to ask if that's for sale, because it's perfection. Also, this table looks just like almost identical to our kitchen table, but different wash, vintage European oak, 4,000. I think we paid about 25 for ours. But this one actually looks like hardier and thicker. Really pretty. And it looks really cute with the bench, but we already did chairs, so we're like, try not to buy any benches because we already spent on the chairs. We're like, we gotta stop.
This is really cool. We're thinking for Hunter's bourbon room and gallery wall.
Another cool piece of art, vintage.
I'm gonna mix the frames.
What is like a French sailor? French? Yeah, French.
Isn't that cool?
Super cool. Look at that. I thought that was a square when I first walked by it. Like it's tucked in, but it's a triangle. It's kind of cool. Unique. I would love a coffee table like this in my office. But it's just, it's probably too big. But I'm really, really into stone lately. So I want to incorporate stone somehow, whether it's coffee table, side table, something like that. I don't know. I want some glass in there, some stone. I want like a really eclectic, diverse range of materials.
That wraps up Big Daddy's.
Oh,
we took the worker around the shop and pointed out the pieces we're interested in.
Yeah,
he's gonna
get quotes
to us, get us a quote on shipping and all that kind of stuff.
See if it makes sense.
And it makes more sense for us, like, if we're gonna ship, like, it wouldn't make sense if we were just buying one thing to ship it, I don't think.
No.
Like, it's, you kind of have to buy in bulk in a way, because they put it in a crate regardless, so you might as well fill up your crate while you're doing it. I mean, that's at least the way we think about it.
I know.
But we'll probably get a quote here in the next couple days and make a decision on which pieces we actually want. And we probably should them, what, like 10?
Yeah, and the light fixture is for sale.
It is for sale.
So excited about that. Would be worth it to me.
That would be worth it.
That's my favorite thing.
That, I'm really interested in that lamp for my office.
The tall one?
The tall one.
Yeah.
The ottoman. And then I really want that art piece. That art piece would make it worth it to me.
Yeah.
I love that art piece.
It'd be a lot of good things.
I know.
Yeah.
Wow.
I know. And they're definitely like the biggest, I would say, like in the country.
Yeah.
With like the best selection.
Yeah. Like a single location.
Exactly.
Yeah, a single store location.
And the plants are on point. If you need plant inspiration, just come walk through here and you will get so many ideas.
And any pot that has a plant with it, like in it, when you buy the pot, you're buying the whole plant. So like some of these like beautiful olive trees are for sale.
Mm-hmm.
Like I was like, shoot, we should ship some olive trees back to Nashville. They wouldn't do very well there.
I just like the trees. They pick really good ones.
I really like the couch for your office. Like a lot.
I know. I've been thinking of a round couch.
I like that one. It's a good color. I like that it's low.
It's just going to be a little bit too big.
I really like it a lot. I'm really digging it. All right, we're waiting on our Uber. Oh look, they have our flower pots.
This is literally how big our planters are, guys.
They're a little smaller than that. Like, we're kind of over-exaggerating, obviously, but they're big.
This is what I feel, how big they feel in the house. They're insane.
They're really good at proportions of plant size to the pot.
They're really good at plants. Yeah. Like,
and sometimes it's a bigger plant with like a smaller, or a bigger pot with a smaller plant. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's, they're kind of the exact same size. Sometimes it's a smaller pot with like a large tree. Like, but they all work really well here.
I know.
Or they put the right plants inside.
They do. They definitely, and they take care of the plants. Like they're all really healthy. That's beautiful. Gorgeous. I want two of these on the front porch.
Yeah. Oh, that's trailing rosemary.
Yeah.
I really like trailing rosemary. It's pretty. If you can. Oh, smell it. What is it about rosemary?
I don't know.
That's kind of what I want my next tattoo to be, rosemary.
Rosemary?
Yeah.
That'd be cute.
It's like my go-to herb.
Herb. Mine's basil.
Yours is basil?
I love basil.
You like mint, though, too.
I love mint, basil, and oregano.
Yeah.
Are my favorites.
But basil is something like, that's a,
basil's like
that's a
shit.
Herb that you really like.
I love it.
Like in pestos and whatnot.
Oh.
But I just love a good rosemary chip, rosemary cocktails.
Yeah.
Just a really pretty and yummy plant. I do like lavender too.
Oh,
lavender
yeah.
smells so
totally.
Good. It looks good too. All right, see you at the hotel. All right, we're waiting outside of our hotel for an Uber. We're heading to dinner. What's the dinner place called?
Angelini.
Angelini.
The Uber situation is intense. Like, nothing available.
Yeah,
they take
it takes 20 like 20 minutes to get here.
They're really expensive. It's really weird. I've never seen that before, so I'm a little confused.
It's interesting, but we're really hungry. We're excited for dinner.
Yeah, it's Italian. It's
gonna be so good. And the hotel we're staying at is called the
Beverly Wilshire.
It's a kind of
old
Four Seasons hotel, kind of an older school, like Four Seasons.
I don't know. I'd recommend it.
Yeah, it was.
A little outdated.
Yes, outdated for how expensive it is. But I think it's like you're paying for
the name
what it is and like where it's at. Like
good
right across from Rodeo. There's Rodeo. And then there's like Via Rodeo. I think is what it's called. Via? Yeah. Something like that. But really good location. Give me a rundown of the outfit.
Okay. I'm gonna think about it. Alright. This is actually, I'm really excited about this. This is a recent Amazon find that I hunted down. I wanted a blazer that was gonna match these shoes. And I was like, where am I gonna find a yellow blazer that matches like that? So I was like, I'll go on Amazon. So it's a men's blazer. It's like $40. I'll link it. Just a men's Hanes tank top cut. Denim shorts are custom by Ali Grace. And then my Bottega shoes and bag. And I think our Uber is here.
Okay, I'll see ya. Here's the rest of my life you need to prove. Every night I'm just forced into two. Okay, so we have to be moved outside, and so we have like a, the outside's really cool, so we're going to wait like 15 minutes for an outside table.
I think it's worth it.
All right, just sat down, and we're out here outside, so pretty.
Beautiful little aperitif.
Yes. And it was like, what kind of bread?
You're going to love this. It has rosemary on it, and it's so good.
Yeah. It's like peach crust.
I think it literally is. It's so good.
We each got a Sangiovese here. Really good. So happy to be here. It's so nice, huh?
I know. The weather is like,
pristine.
Oh my God, yeah.
All right, for starters, we got the bone marrow, as well as the tricolor salad.
What was it? Radicchio? And what else?
It's like radicchio, endive, arugula.
What is that?
It's like corn. And asparagus.
so good. It's like warm. I thought it was going to be like chilly and cold, but so good. That's so good. All right, next course is their homemade
spaghetti
with black truffle. It looks beautiful. Good? Oh yes. All right, I'm diving in. Lastly, we got the branzino. We're officially set. Somebody
I will be killing the mood, like stealing away with the moon. I'm taking it. Hunter looked so cute today. We never got the outfit details. Tell us about it. Where are these pants? Ryan, don't
these
even know.
These pants are from Oil and Lumber.
Oh, the Nashville place?
Yeah.
Cute.
Like custom made.
Let me see what the material. That's cool.
And then these are my YSL boots.
Mm-hmm.
And then this is a...
Oh, Hunter's new favorite brand.
Shirt from Built. Built reached out to me on Instagram and sent me a bunch of shirts.
And their stuff is so good.
It's like athletic clothes, but they're like, they can like double as like nicer shirts. Like, y'all know I love like a basic long tee. This isn't that long. It's not like that scallop necessarily, but like material, come on.
They're such good quality. Yeah, we were really impressed. We never heard of the brand. And then you were wearing it the other day, and our friend was like, oh, that's the only shirts I'll buy for my husband. And we were like, oh, really?
Yeah. Carly was saying that about Jack.
Yeah.
And they sent me a couple colors, but they're like all basic, solid color tees.
Really super nice. Cute.
And I don't know. It was taking like something that's kind of like basic and trying to like dress it up a little bit.
It's cute.
Get ready for bed.
I wanted to give that place a rating.
Oh, okay. Tell me.
What do you think?
I think it's going to get a 9.
9?
Or an 8.5.
Yeah, I was going to say like 8.5.
8.5 only because the food was amazing, but I think that...
It was so good.
We could have had a better table,
mm-hmm.
and the service could have been a little bit better. The server was just kind of like not personable, and he just like rushed.
Yeah.
It
didn't take away from the food.
No, the food was
It maybe took away
so
from the
good.
Experience a little bit.
I would still go back. Like, however, it was that good.
I don't know like what a 10 would be in my mind.
Right.
You know, like what would a 9 be? A 9.5. Like, cause like you're basically saying a 10, it can't get any better than this.
I don't think actually that food was, the food was a 10.
You think so? You think there's no better food than that?
Well, no, there is. I think it's up there though. And I think that what was making it 8.5 was like the service and like maybe the atmosphere.
Yeah. I mean, I really, really liked the food.
Really like,
I loved the food. It was so good.
I loved the food.
So good. Everything.
What would be better Italian than that we've had in America? You know?
I don't know.
And I bet other dishes are amazing.
The pasta was, like, fire. It was $55 spaghetti. But it was homemade noodles.
Worth every bite.
With, like, a cream sauce and truffle. I mean, the truffle is what put the dollar amount probably on the...
Yeah, exactly. Because truffles are like, they're expensive.
But, anywho, really good, worth trying.
I would definitely go. Apparently the roast chicken's really good, so maybe try that if you go.
And we're going to another good dinner tomorrow night with some friends.
Eventually.
And then we've never been there before.
And then we've got to get to Craig's because that's our favorite place.
We've got to get to Craig's at some point. We can't come to LA without going to Craig's.
Craig's is like completely other direction of where we're going to be staying.
But that's a 10 in my book.
It's a 10.
Right.
That's a mother effing
10. It's like
10.
The crispy chicken was like honey on it.
It's like every dish and the environment and it has everything.
It's so good. We're going to Craig's. I'm going to call her.
We're going to Craig's. Oh,
that's one of those ones that you might like if we can't get a reservation. It's like we're going to go and slip them like a dollar bill. Not a dollar bill, but
a bill. You just wait because it's so worth it. Like, I will literally get on my knees and beg you to eat there because it's so good.
Yeah, I'll give you an HJ. Just let me in. All right.
Okay.
When are you ready for bed?
Jammy time.
Good morning, everybody.
Morning.
Another day in LA.
We're walking to Alfred's.
We are.
Luckily, it's like 10 minutes from our hotel, so we walk there every morning, get a little pep in.
It's Sunday morning and it's like so quiet.
We're on walking up Rodeo.
Rodeo, yeah.
And scouting out all the stores that we want to come drop by today.
Wonder what time everything opens.
I know, and actually I was curious if everything's open on Sunday.
I'm sure.
Yeah,
Collages opens a little bit later.
Prada. I love having everything on one street.
Yeah.
So
I'm excited for Alfred's.
Me too.
I was wanting to go to get breakfast somewhere. Should we just do an Alfred's breakfast burrito?
We're just getting a coffee and then we're gonna
make a decision from there.
Yeah, that's why I was trying to get out early.
Yeah.
Just like go grab the coffee and come back.
What's Club Monaco?
This is the Club Monaco I used to work at.
Oh really?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah. This isn't the front, so we should go to the front.
Okay.
I'll tell you while we walk, but yeah, okay, so when I graduated high school, I moved down to LA for 1 year and I went to fashion school. And then I went back
home.
That car. Then I went back home, but my whole year that I lived here, I worked at this Club Monaco on Beverly Drive.
Ouch. You were 17, right?
Yes, I was a baby. And I would come here all the time. And I'll show you where I could get sandwiches on my lunch break. Oh, that's a cute top.
Was this the entry?
This is it.
Would you come in through this way?
Yeah.
That's cute.
It's cute, right? It was good. And I remember actually.
That's cute of you. That's such a cute thing.
I know. I worked with, you know, Xenon on Disney Channel?
Yeah.
Her sister.
Oh, really?
We worked together and I was like, your sister is Xenon. Do you even understand the weight of that?
That's why Julie's always singing Zoom, Zoom, Zoom on her vlogs.
Oh, man.
Anyway, we're gonna grab some coffee and grab some breakfast and then probably spend some time on Rodeo today.
Yeah, do some shopping.
We made it to Offer's. What'd you get?
I got ice vanilla latte.
I just got a oat milk Americano. Americano with splash oat milk. A lot of doggies.
I know, this goes against my sugar philosophy, but
it's alright. I'm drinking a green juice alongside, so good balance.
So many dogs. I miss Booker.
We need to plan breakfast. Where are we at?
The cafe.
We walked from Alfred's, drink our coffees on the walk, and walked to Earth.
Breakfast was so good. I'm just trying to figure out what to get, actually. I'm a little...
We're looking at the menu right now.
I mean, everything looks so good. I think I'm gonna get one of the salmon dishes. Shocker.
The fresh grapefruit bowl.
Ooh.
I mean, I'm not a big cottage cheese kind of guy, but I do like grapefruit.
Oh, just wondering.
By the way, y'all, I quit biting my nails. A habit I give up.
Were you 2 months strong? Oh, a month strong.
About a month and a half. I started right before Greece. They were the longest in Greece.
Good for you.
But my thumb is the only one I'm having difficulty with.
Is it still not growing?
I don't know.
Wait, I thought it was his thumb. That thumb made some progress.
Yeah.
Look at that.
But my, I'm like so proud.
Wait, show the other thumb. That looks good, babe.
Progress.
This one was really short for a while. You couldn't get it past, but it's there.
But I cut my nails. This is like a proud moment. Like, no joke, this sounds so dumb, but I cut my fingernails for the first time with fingernail clippers in my whole life. About 3 or 4 weeks ago. I'd never cut my fingernails before.
Were you excited?
With fingernail clippers. I've always used my chompers. So
it's kind of like a bad habit.
It was a habit I decided one day, like, I'm no longer doing this. I don't like it, and I'm gonna stop. And I stopped.
Cold turkey.
Have faith.
You can do it. If you can do it, you can do anything.
Anyway, talking about biting my fingernails is making me hungry. We'll see all of it. All right, I got the vegetarian huevos rancheros pizza. It's like soy chorizo. And then
I got the salmon toast.
The salmon toast.
Salmon toast. We got some espresso beans to make.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right, dig in.
Matter where the melody would take us, bend or break us, I will never let you down. And no matter how the time is gonna change us, you bring me back around.
All right, y'all. So we didn't say this earlier, but we. Woke up this morning. I woke up at 6. Like almost like I was coming out of a coma. I was like, because I was so hot. It's like so freaking hot. And it was cool in here yesterday. It was like really nice like temperature in here. It was like cold. I like hotel rooms cold. I like rooms cold, sleeping in the cold, all that stuff. Where the freak did my thing go? Shoot. Oh, here it is. But I woke up this morning like hot as shit, and like the room temperature, it was just like so still. It was like no airflow. It was like stale as hell. So I was up at 6. Julie was passed out. I don't want to wake her up. So I was like, let me call down and get some like coffee brought up for room service. Called down for coffee. They were like, sir, I'm sorry, our room service is temporarily closed for the rest of the day because our water pipe here busted in the middle of the night, and so there's no water in the hotel, there's no AC in the hotel. And I was like, oh, there you go. No wonder that it's so hot in here. But yeah, we can't shower, we can't do anything.
And they wouldn't even deliver us drinking water.
Yeah.
Were you just ordering drinking water?
I was trying to get coffee.
Oh, coffee.
I don't know. But anyways, what's funny is yesterday, when we first got here, like, we're staying at a nice hotel. It's supposed to be nice. It's
expensive.
The Beverly Wilshire.
Yes, you guys, it's a Four Seasons.
So like, we're only here for two nights before we switch to another hotel. And we wanted to be comfortable. We're like, let's just splurge. It's only two nights. Let's go for something nice. We went for the Four Seasons, and we got here, and it just wasn't like, even yesterday we got here, and Julie was like, I'm not like loving the vibe here. Like, it's not as nice. Like, you're not really getting what you're paying for and all that stuff. And I was like, well, at least the rooms are cold. Like, at least we're going to get a good night's sleep tonight. And the bed was comfortable.
But minute I walked in the room, I could tell the vibes were not here.
It smells in here. Like, it smells like urine. Like piss.
It smells like stale. It smells like Booker peed a bunch, and then we just left the room
for a year and a half.
For years.
It's like moldy. And
yes.
Stale. So we were gonna just put up with it, but now that the AC is out, we can't take a shower. We don't know when it's gonna be turned back on. We don't want to go to the pool and like get really hot and sweaty, and then come back inside and be like hot.
So
like you want to come back into a room.
It's
anyways.
Like 95 degrees outside.
My long story short, or not really. My long story. Coming to an end. I'm not cutting it short. But an ending and a conclusion of my story is that we called and booked another hotel.
The ending and the conclusion of my story.
God. We're going to another hotel. We're going to
The
Beverly Hills Hotel.
Because I'm like, I don't think they'll mess anything up. Well, I really thought Four Seasons couldn't be messed up, but damn.
So I called down to the receptionist here and I was like, hey, like, this is not a comfortable
And they
state.
Were really nice.
They're really, really nice about it. They're like, sorry, sir, like, we're not going to charge you for your room the second night, and we're going to give you 50% off your first night.
That's very sweet.
So it was really nice of them. And so we're like, we're just going to go somewhere else.
I swear we're not complainers, but you and I have an LA curse. Every time we come to LA,
the one hotel was a bad experience. It's probably gotten better now. It was just so new when we did it last time. But truly, like,
something happens to us every time we're in LA.
We're here to, like, when you're at a hotel and you're paying, like, decent amount of money for a nice hotel room, you want it to be like a nice place. You want it to be a good, comfortable place. And we were willing to put up with the smell in a way. We were willing to put up like just the lack of comfort in a way. Just to sleep on a comfortable bed in a cold room. We were fine with that. And just kind of swallow the amount. But anywho, we're switching hotels. So we're packing up now. We're packing up. And we got to check out here in like 10 minutes. So, yeah, all that to say is that we got a little bit of money back. And we're switching rooms to a really cool hotel. And the Beverly Hills Hotel will be really nice too. And then we're moving to the Dream Hotel for the remainder of the trip.
So complicated.
That was set up with like the brand we're working with for this trip. So, we'll stay at three hotels in a matter of like 4 days.
We're working with Ulla Henderson,
yeah.
Who, the famous Dewtopia serum. Actually, I was thinking you should try this tonight. I did it last night, and
your skin looks really smooth.
I know.
It's shiny.
It's like a game changer.
Is it only nighttime?
Yeah, because it's, and you have to wear sunscreen after, so. But it's nice and glowy.
And it's almost noon, actually, and we can't check into our other hotel until 3. So we're taking our stuff down to the lobby, and they're going to hold it for us down there. We're gonna shop Rodeo and then Uber over to the Beverly Hills Hotel.
Yeah, sorry. Cleaning my
I'm editing that out.
Yeah.
No, I'm not.
I'm literally like sweating.
It's
like hotter in here than it's outside.
I know, I keep thinking to myself like, oh, do I have bad BO or like, is that Julia? But it's neither one of us, it's literally the room. Like, I'm not joking, I'm like, oh, do I smell? And it's like,
it's just like this.
Ew, it's like I'm standing in a puddle of urine.
It's so weird, right?
Yeah. Okay.
All right, let's shit. We're excited to switch hotels, even though this was beautiful.
And we're right on Rodeo, so we figured let's go shopping until our other room is ready. So we're gonna go into all the designer stores. Woo! Fun.
We're at Bottega, and Julie's looking at some bags, some pouches. These are called pouches, right?
Yeah. The purple's kind of cute too, but I don't know. I feel like I'd get sick of that. I kind of like the orange, but also black, like for a dinner
black
bag.
Is classic. It's nice too.
I know, right?
I like the shine on the black.
Yeah. I mean, this is the problem is that I don't have like a small bag that's black. And this I could probably wear in fall. What do you think? Or do I do a color?
You could also wear a color in the fall.
I know. So do I do the orange?
But the color's harder to match with. Like, think about your pink bag. You literally only wear that if you're wearing like neutrals.
I know, I like barely ever wear
it. And then when you're like wearing something that you can wear the pink bag in, will you now grab this bag instead of the pink bag? Like,
maybe.
Will it not be good to have multiple colors?
I know.
Just for your style and taste.
I'm between the orange and the black.
That probably looks really cute with this too, the sneakers.
Yeah, it's cute.
But it is kind of big. Or purple. This is kind of fun. The texture. I like literally don't know.
Hold the blue real quick. That like this light one? Light blue.
I know, he kind of suggested that, didn't he? I just feel like you can't really. This with jeans doesn't necessarily look.
I feel like you came here, and your first grab was that.
The orange. I know. Is that limiting?
I mean, it's limiting, but like, depends like how often you want to wear it and what you plan on wearing it with.
Or purple. I'm not really a purple person.
I like orange.
Yeah.
My only fear is that
I get sick of it.
Not get sick of it. You would just want to be able to wear it enough.
So maybe black. Yeah, see, this is the thing is that I feel like the before Bottega, the colors are like the point.
Get orange.
You think?
I feel like that's what your heart set on.
I like it, it looks cute with this. And it's fallish, right?
Yeah.
Okay, can I do it?
Yeah, if you like it. I feel like you're kind of indecisive though.
I am.
Like, do you want it?
Yeah. I've been wanting one of the minis for a long time.
Here's my view, is I feel like the color Bottega. Colors in Bottega are where it like makes sense.
Agreed.
You can get a black bag and another bag.
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
But I just don't want the orange to get overdone. That's what I'm worried about. Whereas like the black, it's like not as fun, but I can wear it more. I'm trying to think. This is cute. But how many times can you wear an orange bag without it getting annoying, you know? Should I just do it?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do it.
Woo-hoo. You'll be glad.
Okay.
All right, orange it is.
Thanks, babe.
Good pick. She's now looking at the black again. The black looks good.
And I could wear everything, right?
Alright, Juju's so indecisive that we're doing a loop down Rodeo and we're gonna come back to it. Let her think about the black
bag. There's a black bag I want here actually. So we can go here.
Okay. Alright.
Okay, we have made a purchase.
Julia's happy.
Had my eye on this bag for a while and it was the last one he said that they had. So I was really happy about that. And
we'll show it later in the vlog.
Yeah.
But you went black on this one in mm-hmm. case you want the orange Bottega.
Exactly.
To leave that door open.
And I put up a poll on Instagram and most people are saying orange.
Yeah.
I know.
What does Julia want though?
Well, I thought orange originally too. And then, I just don't know. Okay, this is the other thing. Is that now that I'm thinking about it, my sister had that bag and I can't fit my phone in that bag. So that's a little bit of a problem.
Really?
Yeah. So I'm thinking like if I'm out, but I would just hold my phone.
Yeah, or like put it in my pocket.
I'm trying to think.
But then what would you put in there? Like lip gloss? It's literally
yeah, like
it's
my an accessory. ID. I know.
And you can put a sock in there and call it.
I think the green would honestly be the best, but they didn't have the smooth green.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Orange is so in right now, though.
I know, but is it just
will
enough?
It last? Yeah.
And how many times can you wear the orange bag? It's like it's annoying.
I know.
Yeah.
All right, off to some more stores.
We're gonna keep going.
And now we're kind of just like pondering.
Yeah.
Not after anything Everything specific, like, but like just checking out some designer
stores.
Popping in
and out. We don't have any like high-end shopping in Nashville, yeah. So it's fun to like see all the designer stuff.
And I mean, we have time to kill so because of the hotel, so I mean,
we might as well.
Yeah. Whoa.
All right, we're checking into our hotel, our next hotel. And we've never stayed here before, but it's so nice. It's already like incredible so far. Already so much better, the check-in, and the price is like the same. So if you're gonna go like luxurious, I would say here by far, but I don't know, I didn't know that. I just figured the Four Seasons, like you could trust it. No. Oh, thank God. It's cold. Oh my God, this is so nice.
It's just good quality.
Oh, thank the Lord. Wow. Stunning, sorry.
This is nice. You're in the bathroom.
I'm so happy. This is what like, this is what that much money should get you.
I
mean, that was kind of crazy.
You know what's crazy is that we stayed at a Four Seasons before a couple times, but the last one we stayed at was one in Paris. One with my family, with my parents in Paris. And
it was,
that was
like this.
It was amazing. It was amazing. Yeah, it was like this. And then it was kind of like, it didn't feel like the last hotel we were at was a Four Seasons.
No.
And I think that's why it was almost like a letdown. Like, you spend the money and then you're like, oh, it's a Four Seasons. It's gonna be like, you know, top quality, good hotel, and it wasn't.
No.
Like, I'm not trying to hate on it, but I just wouldn't, like, I wouldn't recommend staying there. Unless, like, maybe you're paying to be, like, right there on Rodeo. But even that, it's like, to have Four Seasons on the name, you'd think the hotel quality would be better.
I know.
But anyway, we're not going to harp on that anymore.
Yeah, it's just surprising, like, we're just making the mistakes that you don't have to.
Well, this is cute. This reminds me of the Paris Four Seasons.
Kind this
of.
Is like cozy. Like, yeah. I feel at home. This is nice.
Home? She said home.
Oh, thank goodness.
Cool remote.
Oh my God. Let's get some french fries by the pool. Yes. We also went to, when we went to Zinke yesterday, and all I've been wanting is truffle fries since they got here, and they go, oh, our fry machine is broken. I'm like, your french fry machine is broken? I've literally never heard that in my
we
life.
We get some truffle fries at the pool.
I know, probably. And I think they have really good ones.
Perfect.
They're like the best.
I kind of want to cop out the pool today.
I know, I'm like, this is the vibe. I don't want to check out this place, I want to stay here one extra day.
I know.
We could do that, right? Let's just go to the other place on Wednesday.
And just buy an extra night here?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll see.
Okay, we'll see.
We'll see at the pool. Alright, at the pool. Can't film a ton because
there's no cameras.
There's no cameras.
Sorry, we're just totally
breaking
the
pool. And there's
right
like,
now.
Well, there's like security guards around. Yeah. Well, earlier, Conor McGregor, like right when we sat down, Conor McGregor got here and was across from us. Mm-hmm. And maybe that's why they put up those signs, no photography. Or is it all the time?
Signs, yeah.
But when he came, there was like security making sure no one took pictures, like around all the different pool chairs mm-hmm. and stuff. And they're gone now, so I figured we'd vlog a little bit, but
it's a vibe here though.
She's got a cocktail, Joe got a Diet Coke,
mm-hmm.
I got a rum cocktail.
Okay,
and
very
then,
nice.
And we're having a little snack, a little truffle fries and
so
yellowfin ceviche.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
These are amazing. This is gonna be really good check. Let's see.
Like the room's nice, we showed you. The entry and like this to check-in was a nice experience.
Mm-hmm.
The lobby's beautiful, this pool is amazing, and it's just like a fun like people watching a hotel.
Yeah.
It's worth it.
Definitely worth it.
Anyway, we're gonna put the camera up before we get in trouble.
Yeah, we're
so
we're getting ready. Running late to dinner, and Hunter just sliced open his finger.
On a piece of glass.
On a piece of glass.
Look at that.
Ew. Oh my God.
It needs like the glue stitches, whatever it's called.
The glue shut of like the wound. Okay, so we're going to meet some girls for dinner with their husbands and boyfriends. And so I'm wearing this little winter dress, Zara oversized leather blazer. These shoes are by Femme LA. And then my little Bottega bag. And Hunter's wearing really
sorry,
cute. This is Zara.
This is Zara, yeah. I've worn this shirt before, but I hadn't worn the pants with it. It's like a set.
Yeah.
You can buy them separate, pants or the shirt. I got both, and I have them on with my YSL boots. Like the strap
cute.
Boot. Well, I'm wearing my Miranda Fry necklace.
Really?
I get so many questions about these. One's both the Miranda Fry. One's the Nativity, I think is what it's called.
Yeah, charm.
And then I have my
Mesa Margiela
necklace.
Cute.
Maison.
Okay.
But we did extend our
stay. Our stay, I know. Okay. We need to get you a Band-Aid. Do you have a room key? No. All right, on our way to dinner. It's very dark, sorry. And we're going to Mr. Chow. Is that where it is?
She's here for all I know that she knows it. And my heart gets involved in a shadow.